is a gong with a mallet striking the naked space. So we embedded that. And we also embedded AIM Dream, which is the retail brand for China Mobile.
The longest running dream in the world, 20 years. And yeah, I saw the visual cues in your commercial with the gong coming in there. Tell me, we hear about General Zia's time and how there was one very controversial and Mr. Jawan will wheel me on that, which went in an evening and said, "Huck off to Jatta." And that did not gel well with the establishment back then. And then you wrote a line, perhaps, "Life's a pitch." Is that correct?
I don't think I did that. But I wish I had.
Everybody told me, you
know,
and I kind of loved it. Great. So I just wanted to clarify.
I never said life's a pitch.
I thought that was a brilliant line, life's a pitch. And when life's a pitch was seen, what come there, this is the time when you were doing ANC print rates.
Right.
I kept an eye on you, by the way. I had my eyes on you.
Awesome. We work on Stanley Chocolate, I think, briefly as well.
So this topic came out of your WhatsApp chat last night. So essentially, apart from this great introduction of us by Salman Ali, very kind and gracious author, we are having a filler slot because the speaker could not make it, right?
We're not supposed to be here, so.
Of course, so, but that will not gel well with our egos or the perception of who we are.
You can find anybody on stage, right? I'm just thinking who.
So the topic was this about manners. Do you think it's a stereotype and cliche? Is it really this eccentricity and madness which is an important ingredient to the entire process of creativity?
You know, I can, with a large degree of sort of confidence, say that perhaps 70 is for stupid people. You know, anything with a relationship problems.
You might want to look there. It did not go well with me. Looked in my eyes and you said it's for stupid people.
Stupidity comes
with certitude. I do not take it well.
Stupidity comes with certitude. And any kind of progress, I think, is based on some degree of heresy, some degree of madness. And, you know, so it's all these, any kind of provocations has to come from a place of either, you know, great tyranny or great despair or great isolation. So I think that's the nature of the creative force. And I think anybody who's involved with what I call white paper blues, they face it every day. I don't think it should be taken lightly.
Okay, so backstage we agreed that I'm going to ask you some questions and you would do the same. And you're not. And it's turning into me being an interview.
My mind has gone blank.
Well, you need to ask me something.
Perhaps we can open up the or to our audience members.
Without me having an opportunity to answer.
Okay. I can ask you something that just occurred to me. Tell me about your peacock. See, what inspired you? Why did you think of this particular language?
First of all, this peacock is 80 euros. Feel free to have it. Keep it. PAA came with a very fixed brief. And knowing Salman Ali, the brief is always short and crisp, and then he's on his phone. Right. It was, we must have a peacock.
Oh, really?
It must have truck or color. And I think the delegates by now actually know why it's there, because I started looking at the Indo-Turkic Persian influence of Urdu and Persian script actually, calligraphic arts. And I am a big color, because I grew up seeing the great personalities of my country actually signed their names in Urdu. And I somehow saw that we were moving away from the tradition of the national language. So I make a very conscious effort, be it 4G Foods, be it Geo, be it Neo, be it Half News, most number of news channels that I've launched in Pakistan. I try and live up to the spirit as stated in the Constitution, which was meant for the government, which is Article 259, which is making use of Urdu language, which originally was supposed to be done in 15 years after the Constitution was approved. So, at the cost of being perceived outdated, orthodox, old-fashioned, I have this sense of responsibility towards my country. I am what I am for this great land, and I accept just like a person would accept a lover, with all the faults and everything that needs to be improved in between. So I wanted to induct Urdu in it, and hence this became the first logo in the tradition of Ar-Asia to be rendered in the national language of the host country. Thank you. And if you see the tail, it has 15 parts to it, because they represent the 15 members of the Alpha. And so there was no limitation, it could have been 20. But the odd one out was that USA was part of the Asian Federation. And I love this hegemonic sense of insinuation, whether these are trade bodies, and I see you smiling, Jagdeep Chabasani. And all for the right reasons, all the wrong ones. But yes, this is from where it came. And the good thing about, while I was doing the brand and engineering communication for Ar-Asia, Pakistan Advertising Association, their organizing committee, the past chairman, Ali, was on his phone, and Mr. Hadi was still listening to me. They gave me the liberty. This entire lot of professionals, being advertising professionals, it's hard. Because Hamara Dilemma here allowed me to say a few words in Urdu. Many Angrezi jo hai maine khud seekh liya hai. Kyunki Javed Jabbar jab Kent public mein the, uska standard aur tha jab main aaya, wo aur ho chuka tha. Isliye ye senator aur minister bhi ban gaye, aur main idhar ghumte reh gaye. That it's difficult for the advertising practitioners to actually let someone else have the freedom to create. And thereby I was very, very lucky. Extremely lucky for these men, and including Seema Jaffer, the lady, to actually give me that liberty. Otherwise this would not have happened. And this is, I believe, where the word madness wala part comes in. Client hote wo kehte hain pagal hai, aapke to baal lambe the, mere to bade hone se pehle ke bas ho gaye. The point being, ki na hone se banda zyada creative ho jata hai. If you don't take a shower for 3 days, you're more creative. Believe me, I've showered every day, although the way I look, it doesn't seem. But there was actually a time during this Ar-Asia, by trying. I said to myself, I will not take a shower until I finish the last piece of the artwork for Ar-Asia. And just when I thought it was over, Sandar would have another one for me. So I did not shower for 3 days. So you want to open the floor?
So sure. But just to comment on that, I've sort of noticed the real passion with Urdu and sort of the ethnicity of our local design cues coming out from your work. And oddly enough, I've sort of done the exact opposite, because I think one of the first things that I sort of sensed in our visual culture was the fact that it's not sort of mannered in the way that at least I was exposed to. So a lot of what I brought was this sort of a cosmopolitan vocabulary to a lot of our local brands. But I'm now putting in
when I did the Pakistan Tehreek Insaf scene, the Namjal that you see, much before BMLN adopted it, the idea was to try and modernize, knowing that we have a huge setback in terms of typography. We have not evolved our fonts the way the Persians and the Arabs have.
Absolutely, especially when you see the
word. Right, and we do not see that sense of contribution from Pakistani typographers, which led me to digitize few fonts. Right. And I love playing, and the rest of the calligraphy I do it myself. And I'm hoping for a better visual apology for Pakistan. But that cannot happen without the intervention of policy framework. In the UAE, it is mandatory for you to have the national language. So if in Bangladesh, I think Javed Jabbar sahab had an odd one out, but if you all okay there, to shayad mere mulk ka chhanda bhi aza ho jata. Because I, as a citizen of Pakistan, am not allowed to flutter my flag other than August 14th and March 23rd. And I talk to these lawmakers and parliamentarians each time I meet them, and I get to meet them, and the more I meet them, I get disillusioned, but no disrespect meant. All it takes is private member's bill, a motion to be passed, मेरे झंडे को आजाद कर दो. You want to use the flag on your cars, your vehicles, according to the blue book and the protocol set by the Ministry of Interior. Please use the state emblem. Pakistani flag belongs to the Pakistanis. And it must be seen. Even if we have to fight any kind of merchandising, there's no sort of, you know, merchandising on patriotism. I mean, if you go to any country, then everything from caps and jackets, I mean, the entire visual vocabulary is missing from our culture. I think we can really use that and amplify it. So, should we take questions? Questions? Anybody got some? Yeah. Ask us anything.
Assalamu alaikum.